So now if we talk about the tendency to form complexes, so actually they have very less tendency to form complexes. As we all know that if an element needs to form a complex or if element has a tendency to form a complex, the factor that is responsible is small size, vacant orbitals and moreover high charge density. But when we see in this case, they actually have low charge density and they don't have so small size, so their tendency is actually low. But as we move in a period, we know that there occur a lanthanoid contraction due to which there is a, you can say, abnormal decrease in size, due to which the tendency to form complexes actually increases when we move along the period, right? So this is what is the complex formation. And if we talk about actinoid, again they also form a, their tendency is also low, but still they form, like how they form actinoid halides, they combine with halogens to form halide, their respective halides, and those halides actually can combine with alkali metal halides forming a complex. So this is what we have observed in this case. And in a similar way, as the atomic number increase, size decrease due to actinoid contraction, therefore the tendency to form complexes again increase. So keep in mind, for a metal or a substance to form complexes, the three conditions which are required is the vacant orbitals, the small size and the high charge density. So if any metal is fulfilling all these three conditions, that means it has a tendency to form the complexes. Next is the chemical reactivity. They are actually quite reactive than calcium, but if we talk about their chemical properties, they are mostly similar to the calcium ones, right? But due to lanthanide contraction, their properties somehow get changed and start resembling the aluminium also. So they actually react with hydrogen forming the hydrides, carbon with carbides. They also get tarnished on exposure to air, right? And similarly for actinoids, they are actually radioactive. So you can say that study about their chemistry is somehow very difficult in lab, because they are difficult to handle as they are radioactive. So, but still we know that they also get tarnished in air. Like when they are exposed to air, they form their oxides, they get tarnished, and they are very less reactive towards acid and alkalis. If you talk about acids, they can react with HCl but not with HNO3, because due to formation of protected layer on its surface which actually make it passive towards the HNO3. But still they react with cold water and very fast with the boiling water, forming their respective oxides and hydroxides. So if you talk about the chemical reactivity, the chemical reactivity is not so up to the mark actually, but still they form certain kind of compounds which we have already seen. So this is what is the lanthanides and the actinoids.